Over the past decade, inspired by the United States, China has developed a variety of military drones, including reconnaissance drones, unmanned helicopters, integrated reconnaissance attack drones, and attack drones. Over 200 of these drones have been sold in the Middle East, accounting for 17% of the global market share. In 2023, the first Chinese company specializing in military drones went public, highlighting China's increasing investment in the military drone industry. However, compared to the US, there's still a technological gap in China's drones. Specifically, in terms of long-endurance, high-altitude reconnaissance drones, even though the specifications of the US and Chinese products don't seem drastically different on paper, their reliability in real-world use is distinctly different. Saying there's a generational technological difference is no exaggeration. When it comes to swarm technology and loyal wingman drones guided by AI intelligence, this gap becomes even more pronounced. The underlying reasons are simple yet complex. The free world, such as the US, with its open culture and system, allows for rapid innovation and development. However, it seems the Chinese Communist Party is hemmed in by an invisible wall of autocracy, making it challenging for them to reach the advanced realms of AI-driven drone evolution. At the dawn of the 21st century, the US's Predator reconnaissance drones and Reaper armed drones led the technological revolution in the drone industry. However, the US did not export these designs, aiming to maintain its technological edge. China saw this market gap, and from 2007 to 2022, they replicated several American mid to high altitude long endurance drones, successfully selling over 200 units to Middle Eastern countries. Yet, on Middle Eastern battlefields, China's large cost-effective drones were frequently shot down. The CAIG Wing Lone 2 is one example, with a record of being downed 11 times in just 3 years. The CASC Rainbow drone suffered 7 defeats in just 1 year. The US's MQ-1 Predator, born in 1994, was a pioneering figure in the drone world with its sleek design, satellite remote control technology, and missile launch capabilities. 17 years later, China released its first generation drone, the Rainbow CH-4. Sharp observers could instantly see the striking resemblance in design between the CH-4 and the MQ-1 Predator, right down to their operational principles and methods. Meanwhile, the US MQ-9 Reaper attack drone, introduced in 2001, with its advanced sensor technology and multiple successful missions targeting terrorists, was the stuff of legends in the drone world. Yet, in 2015 and 2017, China launched the Rainbow CH-5 and Wing Lone 2. Keen observers would not miss the significant similarities in appearance between these models and the Reaper. Several US analysts have noted that while Chinese drones might look like their American counterparts, China still needs to catch up in terms of core technology. An Air Force major, an experienced Reaper operator, stated that China would find it challenging to reverse engineer the Reaper's superior sensor technology, pilot control, missile targeting, and data sharing capabilities. In 1998, the US's RQ-4 Global Hawk reconnaissance drone made its debut. 14 years later, China's Chengdu Aircraft Design Institute released its version, the WZ-7, which has a maximum range of 7,000 kilometers, compared to the 26,000 kilometer range of the Global Hawk, revealing the technological gap between the two nations. The Global Hawk's engine is efficient and stable. Not only does it provide ample power during flights, but it also conserves fuel. The latest fuel technology, paired with lightweight aviation materials, further extends its flight range. The sleek design minimizes air resistance, and its advanced flight control system ensures optimal flight conditions, enhancing fuel efficiency even further. Perhaps China's WZ-7 drone only needs to fly over the East and South China Seas and doesn't require the Global Hawk's extensive endurance. Yet, this region is often hit by typhoons. It's said that the WZ-7 was specially designed with double wings to ensure stability during storms. But can this design truly withstand nature's challenges, or is it merely a marketing gimmick? Upon closer inspection, one will find that China's replication in drone engine technology is even more blatant than in design. The US's Predator adopted a piston engine, followed closely by China's Winglong 1 and Rainbow CH-4. As the US's Reaper transitioned to a turboprop engine, China's Winglong 2 and Rainbow CH-5 adjusted their technological direction. The US's Global Hawk embraced a turbofan engine, and China's WZ-7 followed suit. This mimicking of American engine choices raises questions about China's genuine innovation in drone technology. In the cutting-edge realm of drone technology, the US is leading the way in innovation. Drones are evolving from mere flying tools or weapon platforms to highly intelligent combat partners. A prime example of this technological revolution is the XQ-58 Valkyrie drone. This advanced drone, which had its inaugural flight in 2019, successfully completed 6 test flights by 2022. Notably, on August 2nd of that year, it carried out a 3-hour autonomous flight entirely controlled by artificial intelligence. The Valkyrie is not just technologically superior, its features are also impressive. Beyond rocket-assisted launches and parachute recovery capabilities, it's equipped with phased array radar and infrared equipment, giving it unprecedented battlefield awareness. By integrating data from surface chips, unmanned submersibles, and aerospace vehicles, it can independently conduct battlefield reconnaissance, penetrate enemy lines for strike missions, and can even deceive and distract adversaries when manned aircraft are under attack. The Valkyrie's fleet of intelligent drones holds the potential to secure crucial advantages in future naval and aerial combat, possibly even redefining traditional battlefield strategies. In terms of cost, the Valkyrie's benefits are clear-cut. Its procurement cost ranges from $2 to $3 million, significantly less than the $4 million price tags of the Patriot PAC-3 and SM-2 intercept missiles. This affordability has led the US Air Force to plan for the purchase of 1,000 of these drones, intending to deploy them alongside its 300 F-35 fighter jets and 200 NGAD superiority fighters. To ensure continued aerial dominance in the future, the US Air Force has presented a clear financial request to Congress. Allocate $1.9 billion for the next generation air superiority fighter program in 2024, and another $500 million for aircraft designed to work in conjunction with it. These funds will be channeled towards the research and procurement of technology related to the Valkyrie, aiming to have it fully operational in the US military by 2030. Meanwhile, the CCP is striving to develop a counterpart drone, named the Shadow. However, compared to the Valkyrie, the Shadow project appears to be lagging slightly in development speed and technological breakthroughs. Recent declines in the Shadow drone's online visibility have sparked widespread public interest and speculation about its progress. As the world speculates about future naval warfare, many eyes are drawn to drones bustling with takeoffs and landings on aircraft carrier decks. In this context, the US's MQ-25 Stingray and MQ-9B Sea Guardian play pivotal roles. The MQ-25 Stingray, a unique refueling drone, not only possesses the capability to operate on a carrier, but its stealth features also allow it to refuel the F-35 stealth fighter without revealing the latter's position. The MQ-9B Sea Guardian, capable of vertical takeoffs and landings on carriers, can monitor distant enemy ships and submarines and even launch attacks on them. In fact, 2 such swords are already deployed on India's aircraft carriers. Then there's the MQ4C Triton, a maritime variant of the Global Hawk series. Since its deployment to Guam in 2020, it frequently conducts joint exercises with the P-8A anti-submarine patrol aircraft over the South China Sea. This is genuine preparation for war. The Americans always emphasize action over words. Turning our attention to the CCP's progress in this domain, their research and development in carrier-based drones, stealth drones, and maritime reconnaissance strike drones have yet to yield boastful results. Hypersonic technology is hailed as a game changer on the modern battlefield. The US continuously advances and innovates in this area, having successfully tested the hypersonic drone Mayhem. This drone can fly near the ground within the atmosphere, achieving an impressive 5 times the speed of sound. This is all thanks to its cutting-edge scramjet engine technology and the application of a series of high-temperature resistant materials. In contrast, the CCP still has weaknesses in basic aviation engine research. When it comes to advanced scramjet engine technology for hypersonics, the gap might be even more pronounced. In the development of special materials that withstand high temperatures and pressures, the CCP also faces technological challenges. If the US truly deploys these hypersonic drones, then any high-value targets of the CCP could potentially be within their strike range. This means that in any potential conflict in the Taiwan Strait or the West Pacific, the military and political elite of the CCP could face existential threats. Of course, China has also showcased its developments in hypersonic technology in the past and claims to have successfully tested several hypersonic weapons. However, based on publicly available information, the technological reserve that China has in the hypersonic drone field still shows a clear gap compared to the US. Drone swarm technology is hailed as the game changer for future aerial combat, poised to reshape battlefield strategies and tactics. Though the CCP actively promotes its advancements in this area, available data suggests that the West, particularly the US and UK, undoubtedly still lead in this technology. The US's X-61 Gremlins project has showcased impressive technological breakthroughs. Developed in collaboration between the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency and Dynetics, this jet-powered drone is unique in its ability to launch and recover drones in midair, significantly enhancing operational efficiency and cost-effectiveness. Simultaneously, the UK's multi-drone, multi-layered warfare system has achieved beyond visual line-of-sight autonomous flight. This system, tailored for electronic warfare, can simulate electronic decoys to deceive enemy air defense radars, offering the British Air Force a significant strategic advantage. In stark contrast, the CCP has been relatively cautious in its drone swarm technology research. While the Golden Eagle 150B demonstrates the capability to deploy small bombs, public knowledge about its specific tests and performance remains limited. Furthermore, the CCP has yet to provide clear answers on how to coordinate these drones, the implementation of swarm tactics, and strategies for large-scale network management. Clearly, the future aerial battlefield will be dominated by highly intelligent drones with unparalleled stealth capabilities. In this aspect, the US military stands at the technological forefront, fully prepared. Meanwhile, the CCP is still navigating this technological domain. The gap in drone technology between China and the US has garnered widespread research and attention. To comprehend the reasons behind it, we must delve deeply into their respective technological R&D, management, and cultural dimensions. Firstly, the management and transparency of R&D investment plays a crucial role. The US defense budget undergoes open and transparent scrutiny and is under stringent oversight by the legislative body, ensuring funds are genuinely allocated for technology research and maximizing benefits. In contrast, some opinions suggest that China's R&D funds might lack transparency. There might even be some misappropriation and corruption, with only about 10-20% truly channeled into research. Cultural differences also play a significant part. The US has long promoted technological innovation, adhering to the belief that failure is the mother of success. Such an optimistic mindset continually fuels its technological advancements. Meanwhile, China tends to focus on short-term specific technological goals, which in some respects constrains the long-term accumulation and innovation in technology. Practical combat experience is another pivotal factor. US drone technology has been tested and refined in numerous real-life combat scenarios, whereas China has relatively limited combat testing. Regarding technological standards and implementation, the U.S. boasts a rigorous legal framework and ensures its strict enforcement, undeniably providing a clear direction for technological R&D. On the other hand, while China has established strict regulations, they are rarely enforced. Moreover, the Biden administration's export restrictions on China's high-tech industry pose a significant challenge to the development of China's drone technology, especially in the realm of artificial intelligence. Due to the constraints on high-end chips like NVIDIA and Intel, China's progress in related technological fields could lag considerably. Most notably, the untimely demise of Feng Yanghe, a Chinese AI scientist hailed as a genius in a car accident, undoubtedly dealt a profound blow to China's advancements in AI. This indirectly impacted the swift development of its drone technology.